Are you happy? Like at this exact moment, this very second, can you say that you are happy? What makes you happy? You know, if those questions were actually asked in a job interview, I'm pretty sure a whole lot of us are just gonna flop that interview. You know, what I find really funny is nowadays people need to take like a 10, 20 question quiz in order to know if they're happy or not. I'm not saying that it's lame, but I'm calling it for what it is. It's lame. You should know if you are happy or not. It's not just a feeling, it's a sense of being. So when you say it's a sense of being, it's a conscious choice. Happiness is a conscious choice. You may not like the idea of it being a conscious choice because we always tend to go against the flow and just pick the negative. We want to be unhappy. We want to feel miserable. We want to feel sadness. I don't know why. Sometimes you just need to stop, take deep breaths, look at what you have. Look at where you have been and where you are at now. Just takes a little bit of introspection, and you're gonna see how much progress you have made. So that's one way of being or measuring your happiness. Another is if you feel contented. For me, happiness is just a byproduct of contentment. If you are really contented with who you are right now or what you have right now, then goodness, you don't need to be a billionaire. You don't need to be a gazillionaire in order to be happy. You don't need to be a successful business person or person who climbed up the career ladder in order to be happy. We really don't need those outward measures of success in order to know if we are happy or not. For me, those outward measures of success is actually just a means to compare. And honestly, that's where the discontentment actually lies, especially in today's modern age. It's so easy to feel discontented today, rather comparing it to when it was 200, 300 years ago. In the golden age of information technology, where you can access almost anything in the snap of a finger, it's also very easy for you to compare yourself to others. Social media, instead of it connecting us, it's actually the number one root cause for being or having this feeling of being disconnected from your friends, from your colleagues, from your peers. Why? Because we choose to look at other people's social media accounts and then we tend to compare their lives against ours. It's counterproductive. Instead of you being happy for this person, you tend to feel jealous about it. And that's not the purpose of social media. The purpose of it is actually to get us all connected, even if we are physically miles away from each other. So I don't understand why. Is there a need for other people to compare themselves to others? That's a great way to feel unhappy. Because your journey is different from another person's journey. All you need to do is look at yourself. I'm not saying be narcissistic, it's just that you have to focus on yourself. If you got thousands of followers on Instagram, if you got thousands of friends on your Facebook, you got what? How many thousand followers on your Twitter account? That means nothing if you don't know who you are, if you don't know who your real friends are. So please, the next time you open those accounts, the next time you look at yourself in the mirror, ask yourself, am I truly happy?